Okay, so in this set of video lectures, we're going to go ahead and talk about the markets for factors of production. And mostly we're going to go ahead and talk about labor markets because most of us get most of our income from labor markets, so that's the most interesting to us. But just recall that there are multiple factors of production. There's land, also sometimes called natural capital. There's physical capital. So machines, raw materials, inventories of raw materials that are still in the ground would be part of natural capital. And then we have labor. And sort of when people were originally writing economics back in, say, the late 1700s, early 1800s, when they talked about labor, they were mostly talking about unskilled labor, because at that stage of the Industrial Revolution, countries like England were basically pulling people out of agriculture, and they may have had skills in agriculture, but often they were illiterate, and they didn't have any skills that were particularly relevant to the new industrial economy. Nowadays, we sometimes divide this up into sort of raw, unskilled labor, and also human capital. Because we think that just like physical capital, having more and better tools can increase a worker's productivity, so having more and better education or other forms of training, on-the-job training in particular, can make people more productive. Then we get into sort of some hair splitting here. Some people want to throw in entrepreneurship as a fourth factor of production. And we will see if I can successfully spell entrepreneurship. I think that's right. Some people want to call it a fourth factor of production. I myself would call it a particular specialized type of human capital, but this is really sort of not an important distinction. So we do want to realize, though, that there is part of what's going on in the market for factors of production is a market for something like entrepreneurship and leadership and the ability to come up with new and better products and that kind of thing. Okay, so the markets for factors of production are going to be the market for all of these things that firms can use to produce goods and services which they can later sell. And they're all going to depend upon the productivity of these different factors of production. The more productive a resource is, the more a firm's going to be willing to pay for it. And that's going to be the overarching theme that we're going to run through in these, even though all of our examples are basically going to be oriented around the labor supply and labor demand. So we'll go ahead and get into that in our next video segment.